Hi, I'm Tiffany from Cal State Dominguez Hills Athletics Department, and welcome to the Toros Coaches Corner. I'd like to welcome the head coach for baseball, Murphy Sua. Talofa, Coach Sua.
Talofa.
Welcome to the Toros Coaches Corner. Dominguez Hills had a solid season last year, hosting the NCAA West Regional Tournament and having three players sign on with Major League Baseball teams. Tell us what the team learned from that experience and how we will fill the shoes of those three pitchers.
Well, the experience of hosting the regional, even just playing in the regional, is you can't put a price on that. That's the experience that as young men are able to remember for a lifetime. And that just strengthens our program to know that we can play in the regionals, and we've done it back-to-back years, which is quite special as well, too. So that's going to help our team in the future with the experience of being in the regionals and even hosting the regionals. The three players that just signed professional contracts are special, especially young men with special tools. And, of course, that helps our program because when people see that we are putting guys in the pro ranks, it makes our program much more attractive.
Now, you pegged Shane Youngsdale as the new workhorse after the West Region Tournament last year. Is he ready for that role?
Well, absolutely. He would have been ready for last year as well, too. We had some strong pitching. He is probably one of our best athletes on the on our team. There might be two or three guys that are at his caliber. He can do everything. He can hit, he can run, he can pitch, and he's going to be a workhorse for us this year and be our number one coming out of the gate.
The Toros returned two All-Americans in Abel Medina and Kevin Pillar. Can they help guide this offense to its most productive offensive year in Toro history?
Those are two pretty potent players. They are absolutely special hitters. I think they're going to be surrounded with very, very good players. To be the best in the program's history, I don't know, because we've had some very good programs, some good hitters in the past. But I think that we will be one of the top hitting teams, top offensive clubs that the school has seen.
Now, what do you, as a head coach, look forward to the most with this year's squad?
Well, you know, we're going to have a lot of players coming. We've graduated 10 seniors, and we're going to be probably bringing another 10, maybe 15 players. So it's going to be a learning year for many of the players. But I really, really look forward to teaching the concepts of baseball. And, of course, academics is huge for us as well, too, for the baseball program. And we're looking forward to just teaching the new men coming in. And I've got a good, really good feeling about the classes we have. We've got a pretty good recruit class, and we're excited about getting them on the field.
And what can people expect to see when they come out to watch the Toros this season?
Energy. Energy, energy, energy. Lots of energy. Our players play with energy and they play with passion. We hope to put on a very good show every time people come out to see us play. And we're hoping to get a lot of people to come out because we're going to be a pretty exciting team.
Well, thank you, Coach. I thank you for your time. And I want to thank you for joining us in this edition of the Toros Coaches Corner. And until we see you in the stands, remember to make every day your masterpiece. And go Toros.
Go Toros.